Hey guys, welcome to another Mic'd Up Motorsports video. Have limited time, but I wanted to do another video today. I did a NASCAR Racing 2003 video earlier. So before I jump on to PS4 and play some EA NHL 18 hockey with my oldest son, I thought I would try to get this video, just a real short video in the can, and I thought about, well, what can I do that's going to not be very long? I'm going to do a one lap of the Tourist Nordschleife, and I've not done it yet. I don't think I've ever driven this car, as a matter of fact. This is a Lamborghini Countach, and I read some of the information on it, and I know they made it from like 1975 to 1990. I don't know, I'm not a Lamborghini Countach expert. So I can't tell by looking at the car exactly what year it is, and it didn't really say. But the last year that it talked about in the video, it said something about 1985. So I'm thinking it might be like around a 1985 model. It definitely does not look like the older model, for sure. Just based on the wing and just a little bit of the other aspects of the car, bodywork-wise. So I'm going to jump into this car here and see what kind of a lap I can do on the Nordschleife, the current modern Taurus version, which I've been doing some of the other videos of different cars on this, and I think the fastest I did was like just under a 7 minute lap, and I think that was in the LaFerrari. I know if it wasn't, it was very close. It was up there as far, I think it was still my fastest lap on the Nordschleife. But I'm gonna go ahead and jump into this real quick here and see what kind of a lap I can do. And so here we go. I already have the fuel adjusted to what I think is plenty, but not excessive amount. Okay, checked out the retro interior. Pretty cool looking, I must say. Here we go. Can't see the hood in this car. It's steeply sloped. Whoa. It's got those really small in diameter wide tires that look kind of funny on this car. Actually handles pretty good, feels pretty good actually. Nice stable handling so far. Manual shifting with my G27 Logitech wheel. Smooth acceleration. Doesn't feel like the fastest car I've ever driven. But it's not the slowest either, obviously. Whoa! Now this is, I've never driven this car before, so I hope I don't, like, throw it off the road. I don't know really what it's capable of as far as, whoa! Oh, what save? I'll take that save. Phew! I can't believe I saved that and didn't hit the guardrail. I thought for sure it was in. Brakes squealing, metallic squeal, and sideways under acceleration. This car is a little bit of a handful. I'm gonna try to take it easy, but still turn as quick a lap as I can. That minor mini almost spin cost me a few seconds, for sure. Actually feels pretty good now, once you get the hang of it, but a little bit of oversteer there on acceleration. Fighting the wheel. Oh, definitely tail happy this car is. Just gotta keep it on the track. Don't forget, this is a one-time lap with no practice with this car, so I'm probably only driving about, I don't know, 90%, just to be safe. Most of the time, just based on the fact that I don't really know the car, sometimes I might be approaching 100% or over, because I don't know the limits. So I might accidentally be going over the limits or near the limits of this car. And my limits. turned in too quick there. Fast. Oh, blinding speed down through here. We'll unlock up a little bit on entry to that little kink. Through 8 hour forest now. Stay in second. Just try to stay on the track and get a solid quick lap time. Go, go, go. Oh, look at the sunlight effects on the windshield. That's amazing. I'm not all about graphics, but man, when you have a game that's this good and the graphics that it has, and I don't have a top-of-the-line computer as of the year 2018, which is when I'm making this video, my computer's probably top-of-the-line about 2014. Maybe not even that. Because I think this game is from 2014 and I can't run it maxed out. Not quite. It's on like medium high average graphics. Or an average of medium high graphics. Whoa. Whoa! Gets loose under trailing throttle also. Whoa, kicking the rear end out there. Up on the curb there. Gotta be careful I don't go wide here. Ah! Making the transmission unhappy. Shift down the second to go up this hill. Whew. Coming up to Bergworks here. Oh god. Almost too fast entering there. Decreasing radius turn. Now it opens up. Doesn't really have the acceleration that I thought it would have, but then it is an older car. But it's a V12. Isn't it 5-something liters? Oh shit, almost too fast through there. I wasn't sure. I actually wasn't as fast as I thought I was going to be. It looked like it was going to be worse. This car has a good amount of front end grip. If anything, it's a little on the loose side as far as handling, as you can see right there. I don't know if it's going to stay down in the banking or not. It's awfully low ground clearance. Did. I wasn't the fastest through there, but then I'm not the fastest through there either. So, I'm not a big fan of the carousel, actually. It's cool looking, but I just don't like driving it. I don't know whether to be second or third gear in these turns. Probably third. Second's going to be a little bit on the oversteery side. I'm going to stay third, I think, through here. Go, go, go. Down to second here, though. Because this turns a little tighter at the bottom of the hill here. There we go. YouTube corner dead ahead. Hopefully not embarrass myself at YouTube corner. It's actually not a bad handling little car. It's a little scary at times. But overall, it's... doesn't seem to be ill-mannered if you just know how to drive it, which I'm not saying I do, but whoa, almost too wide there, but recovered pretty well. I said, I'm not trying to break any records here, just trying to put in a good for a first lap of this car on this track. Just trying to keep it on the track and do a quick time. I feel like the way I'm driving it now and learning about the car a little bit, I could probably do 15 or 20 seconds better than this lap's going to be easily. Or could easily do 15 or 20 seconds better, I should say. Now that I know a little bit more about the limits of the car and how it does on this track. Almost to the gantry. Bridge to gantry. Almost complete. And... oh, that's a terrible time. An 8:15. That's way off the LaFerrari. I forget exactly what the LaFerrari time was, but it was a lot less than 8:15. Yeah, I could easily do under 8. This definitely is not a speed demon as far as modern cars, at least in this sim. I don't think you'd ever be able to get this car to do an under 7. I don't think even a race car driver could do that. No, I don't think so. There's virtually no way. It just doesn't have what some of the modern cars have. But there it is, guys. 8:15. Not very good. Definitely could have done better. Jump ahead a little bit here and see what's up. There we go. This is where I almost lost it. Ugh. Let's watch a little bit of the footage to see. Look at it. It's a gorgeous car. It looks absolutely beautiful. If you like that iconic Lamborghini Countach styling. Some of the earlier models were definitely more odd looking even than this. The angular lines, some of the earlier models were a bit bigger and boxier looking. Not quite as smoothed out as this one is. With the V-shaped rear wing. I'll jump ahead a little bit here. A little tail happy there. I'm going to get rid of this. Coming up here. I unloaded the suspension, but no air. Wasn't looking to get air there. That would have been even if I could have, that would have not necessarily been a good thing. This is always a cool shot coming up through here. And then down, I forget the name of this corner, Kaltenbach or something like that. And then they run down the hill. Shot there. This is a neat speed shot. Ugh. Yeah, that's definitely way slower than the LaFerrari was. The LaFerrari just flew through that section. I mean, it was a clear speed shot when the LaFerrari went through there. When I did the replay through the Adenauer Forest, and did pretty decent through there. Not breaking any records though, like I said. I wasn't pushing it that hard, but I think I would be hard-pressed to get under a 745 with this car. I don't know what... I wonder what this actually did on the Nordschleife. I'm going to have to look that up. I probably should have looked it up before the video. But... let me jump forward a little bit. Nice engine note as well. Really cool looking. I'm wondering, I think I have street tires on this car. I don't know if there was an option to use slicks. If they would have been faster, they probably would have been considerably faster, because they usually are on just about any car. More rubber gripping the road as long as it's dry. Oh, nice. The poppity pop of the exhaust under deceleration. And on down, or no, upshifts, rather. Lap almost complete. Nicely through the Belloff S's. Shadows of the chain link fence on the side of the car and the angled sunlight, the steeply angled sunlight through the mini carousel, a little bit wide on exit there. Last couple of turns before the gantry timing stop. Yeah, not breaking any records with this car, I wasn't. And there's the lap. The track looking like a white river in the glare of the afternoon sun. As I decelerate towards the pits, completing my lap, 8:15 and some odd tenths, hundreds, thousandths. So there you have it, guys. Into the pits, the tourist pits. If you stayed with me this long, thanks a lot for watching. And just wanted to do a quick little video. Not that interesting, necessarily. Fun to drive, though. And could have definitely done better as far as a lap time. But like I said, I've never driven this car before in this sim. And didn't want to like throw it off the road and completely ruin the lap, so that's the time I got, and I guess I'll have to live with it for now. Might try to do another one later, and I'm gonna look it up and see if anyone did what someone did as far as lap time on the tourist track with the Lamborghini Countach. But that's it for now, guys. Thanks for watching, and if you like the video, click it. If you haven't subscribed yet and you want to, click that. And if you want to be notified when I post new content, click that little bell and you will be notified. And with that, I will see you guys around.